Here's a look at some of the pictures our viewers snapped of that storm damage. Maple Grove, Osceola, Forest Lake, and East Bethel. Each city had downed power lines and trees. And in St. Croix Falls, a home actually moved off its foundation. And that's where Ivory Hecker joins us live. Ivory?
Julie, a family of four was inside the home here on 123rd Avenue when strong winds pushed this home more than 20 feet off of its foundation. You can see here where the home was and where it is now. The family inside was uninjured but shaken.
Trying to wrap your mind about like what happened, how did this happen?
Sara Nelson is sorting through the mess left by last night's storm.
All I could hear was just stuff shattering and probably breaking and falling.
She says it was about 2 a.m. when the power went out and the fan shut off.
As I'm on my phone about to pull up the radar, I see out of the corner of my eye, my very large China hutch just going like in the opposite direction from the wall. And I felt the house moving. I heard the very, very loud, like, I can't even explain what the noise was. It was just very loud.
She grabbed her boyfriend and two sons and took cover.
And we all shoved into the closet, and literally we were in there 5 minutes, and all of a sudden it was just quiet.
Nelson says the storm was quick but devastating.
My youngest one probably took it the hardest. But we lost our cat, which was his cat. And he passed away.
9-year-old Alex found his cat Oliver in the living room.
That's just very hard for me to see him devastated by losing like his best friend.
Still, Nelson is counting her blessings.
I'm just glad my kids are okay.
The family will stay in the Holiday Inn tonight, and several friends have offered up their homes until the family can rebuild.
That's the only place to go. We just keep moving forward.
County sheriff's officials say the Nelson home was the worst hit, but if you look over here, other homes on this street also had significant roof damage. And just down the street, about 180 feet of large fencing around the Menards store was knocked down by the wind. Sheriff's officials say, fortunately, there were no reports of injuries due to the weather. Back to you.
It's amazing no one in that house, none of the people were hurt. Thank you, Ivory.